Hey there, friends. Thanks for checking in. It's time for another Handgun Showdown, where the viewers of this channel decide which company makes the better handguns. This one is going to be a little different. We are comparing budget handguns versus moderately expensive handguns, and I see both sides of the issue quite often. You have the budget people that say, I could buy two of these for the cost of one of these. I trust my life with these guns. I have no problem carrying them. But yet you have the other side that says, that makes no sense to me. Pay an additional $150, $200, get a better quality gun, and have the peace of mind of knowing that it will be there when you need it. So this will be a good one, and I'm really looking forward to getting back the responses. But before we do that, we need to report the results from the last Handgun Showdown, where we featured Canic versus Car Arms. This was a very good Handgun Showdown, but in the end, Canic took it. People loved the capacity, the features, and the price of Canic handguns, and they won this showdown. But let's get after budget handguns versus expensive handguns. Let's start with budget handguns, and what I'm basing this on is something in the mid-200s, maybe less, maybe a little more, but those are considered budget handguns. And let's start with the popular Taurus G2C. A lot of people love this gun. 12 round magazines, single action trigger, feature loaded with thumb safeties, accessory rail, loaded chamber indicator, you name it, it has it, and it's budget priced. You know, at a point it was selling for right around $200, $210, and this is an extremely popular model, and I think that model brought back Taurus in the eyes of many shooters. Here we have a single stack 9mm. It's a Bursa BP9cc, carries 8 rounds, but people love this gun as well. It does have a magazine disconnect, but an incredible trigger. 3.3 inch barrel, a sharpshooter. I shoot this gun incredibly well. I've always enjoyed it. Many people love Bursa products, and this BP9 is a compliment to their series of handguns. How about a larger handgun? This is a Remington RP9, full size with a 4.5 inch barrel, 18 rounds in the magazine. I believe I picked this up for around $250. And it's got a sweet single action trigger, extremely accurate with that long barrel, nice trigger, good ergos. I'm very happy with it. And it's just performed very well for me. After I had an initial issue, I did have an initial issue with that, but Remington fixed it up for me, and it's been fine ever since. And over here we have a Diamondback AM2 with a 3.5 inch barrel. I'm very much impressed with this. 12 round magazines. You know, it's got the front serrations, the pick rail, nice trigger, striker fire indicator, you know, 3-dot sights with an orange front dot. I love this gun, and I can speak the same with all these other ones. Budget guns. There's definitely a soft place in my heart for budget guns, and I think this group of four represents them very well. Here are four what I would consider moderately priced handguns, right around $500, maybe give or take $50, but I really like these four, so let's talk about it. Here we have the Glock 43X, 10 rounds in the magazine. And it was a big hit when Glock introduced this a couple years ago, and I was able to get a hold of one and have kept it ever since because I think they did a nice job extending that grip, offering 3-finger contact on the gun. And aftermarket magazines are available, as well as many other aftermarket parts, which is so consistent with Glock handguns. How about the FNS 9C? I've owned this one a while. It's ambidextrous. It has 12 rounds in the magazine, and definitely a straight shooter. This one has night sights. I probably had this for 4 or 5 years, and I am yet to experience a failure of any kind. It has eaten, fed, fired, and ejected every single round that I fed it, and it continues to this day to perform excellent. Love this gun. This is a CZP10S. It is optic ready, so this would be considered the most expensive with these. But with an MSRP of $577, street price, probably close to $500, maybe a little bit more. Front serrations, a very nice trigger pull. It offers everything that the P10C does, but a little bit smaller with the 3.5 inch barrel and 12 rounds, but I've got an base plate there that offers 14 rounds, but incredible. CZ Handgun, I think they did an amazing job with this, and like the rest of these, I've really enjoyed owning that since day one. But here we have the Walther PPQ with a 4-inch barrel, more of a compact size. Huge fan base with the PPQ line, and I'm part of that fan base. An incredible trigger, cross-directional texturing on the grip, a rail. It's one of the lighter handguns in the polymer class, but straight shooter, a nice handgun all around. Many people even carry these. I have to say, I'm a fan, and I think that this sample of four represents moderately priced handguns quite well. So which is your preference? Are you into budget handguns or moderately priced handguns? Both? Or do you try to hit that sweet spot in between? If you like videos like this, please subscribe and share. I always appreciate the thumbs up button. Thanks for watching, and you guys be safe.